Hello beautiful people, this is Mimi and in this video we'll be reading chapter 2 of Queen Bee. Let's get started.
Well, I don't know what to think about this. I read some comments about how this book is really problematic and everybody's fighting. And it is true. Everybody's really nasty. Even like your friend Zoe, when you were talking to that other guy with glasses, she was like, "You shouldn't talk to him because he's like a bottom feeder. Like, he'll make your reputation worse." And I'm like, isn't the point of this whole thing to try to make things equal for other people, like overthrow the whole system? And you can do that if you're gonna be doing the same thing as what's her face. I forgot. Poppy. Yeah, Poppy. If you're gonna be the same, then this is gonna turn into Mean Girls, right? By the way, this reminds me a lot of Mean Girls. And also the whole situation with Ian and the main character reminds me of Pretty Little Liars with Arya and, well, I forgot the guy's name, but the way they met at a bar, and then they start making out, and then they figure out that he's her teacher. But here, the main character is of legal age, so it's not as much of a problem. But I'm still a little bit uncomfortable about how the main character is really comes on really strongly towards the professor. Maybe like be a little flirty, but I think she's being a little bit too, I don't know, forward. And I did choose to like stay with him because I want to know the information. I'm gonna try to dial it back as much as possible. Not as much as possible, but maybe not go all the way and pick all the flirty choices. I like him. I am just a little afraid that this is gonna turn into the same thing with Ethan, where this is a forbidden relationship and you're just gonna go back and forth between, I want you, we can be together. Oh no, this is wrong. And it is kind of wrong. The power dynamic is not good. And kind of like the Nanny affair, but I don't care. Because these stories, I just like take them as like a Harlequin story where like a bunch of crazy things happen that in real life I would not stand for, but this is entertainment and we know it, right? And that's how we enjoy our lives. We can do things that we would not do in real life, that would not be smart. A lot of choices that are made in these games are just plain stupid. But since it's choices and it's not a Leaves Beneath, even then, I'll probably not end up killing your character. They'll let you know when they're gonna die. It's really obvious. What else? So I don't want to turn into a horrible person. I thought that maybe you were going to go after Poppy's boyfriend. I forgot his name, Carter, but he just doesn't seem like somebody that would be a love interest. I don't understand why he's still with Poppy because she is horrible. And he seems to think that she's not horrible because he even told like her friend, whose name I don't remember, Poppy would not agree with the thing you did to the main character. And I'm like, no, I think she would ask her to do it. So he's just crazy. I like the frat boys. How they stood up for you. It's like, yes, now I have an army under my thumb. Yes, baby, I'm the queen. Of Jello World. Okay, that's it for this video. I've talked too much. I've ran too much. I'm sorry if this is late, but I'm really tired and I'm moving, so I don't have as much time and I might not have a very good internet connection for a little bit because I have to set up the internet and it's a whole mess. Okay, that's it. I've said too much about my personal life. Okay, I'll see you in the next one, beautiful people. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye bye.